I'll invite him again. But, oh. And there were some others that I invited, but you say that the invites are sticky. Okay, so Cornelius. Character Olog. Olog. Okay, that'll be interesting.
I really thought for an hour to try and come up with a name. I saw something like written down somewhere, and that's where it came from.
Okay. That's gonna get confusing because I keep calling Doug Uma, and now I've got Ola. Okay. I will learn this name.
So let me, since I can, I'll start. I'll just show you. These are my worksheets. So this is my master. This is the Tiglath Experience worksheet, and it keeps track. I keep track of everybody who plays, what character they play, what race, what class, what gender, and then I actually bought, this is where I give award all the experience, and I total up the experience, and I actually calculate what level you are based on your experience. So it works out well. And then on a, this one here you can't see all of, but you can see some of, this is my, individual adventure worksheet where I list the character. I copy from one from here, so Noah just showed up, so I get to, so I go Noah with Xanatar.
Oh, so you have like a master one and then sponsor.
Yeah, and so what happens is this, well, this one is the one for each individual. This gives me the individual one, so I see who's. So I have all this, and then I have my encounter sheet, which calculate how I keep track of. Yeah, I'm, shall we say, a tad insane. I admit that freely about this because I just get a little bit.
But just yeah. A tad.
Just a tad. Yeah, it's you know, it's it gets me. Yeah, it started off. I can't remember what happened. Was I disliked what was I had? What was his name? One character who kept really pushing for me to move to roll 20, and I didn't want to move to roll 20. And so, yeah, I know it does a whole bunch of things for people, but it doesn't do things the way I do them. So that was one of the challenges that I had with Roll 20 is that you have to do it, you have to work the way it wants to work. So anyway, okay. So now I've got Cornelius, I've got James, I've got Crystal, I've got Michael, and I got Noah. Okay. So we've already started, and let's stop presentation there. And then I heard, of course, a plank. So what the hell? Giant wolf spider. That's okay. Giant wolf spider. Oh, that's one of your companions? Okay. That's and Ben Smith. One more. Okay, good.
Turn off your Ben. Jeffrey, turn off your notifications in Hangouts. That way, you won't keep hearing pings.
I just shared that because that's my companion.
So that's under settings for isn't that settings?
And my phone is restarting, so I'll be flipping devices here in a sec.
Okay.
Yeah, you go into that. You turn when you go to not that. Just a sec. Okay, when you know where it says new conversation at the top, and you see the arrow on the Hangouts like line thingy. Do you see what I'm talking about?
No.
Go right to the top.
So this here, right?
I don't know. Let me see. Share what you're share what you're hitting, and I can tell you.
Okay, so this.
Okay, no, yeah, okay, you see over where it says invites? Up at the very top on your, what hand is that? That's your right hand side. Way up at the top. No, you keep going. There, go over right. You see invites? Okay. Now wait, there's something in the way, and I can't see. There. Okay. You see that little arrow at the end of new conversations? No, keep going over. Yeah, click that. See where it says notifications, sounds for incoming messages. Click off. There you go. You won't get that now. Done. Just remember to put it back on.
Okay. Okay.
Now stop sharing.
So, all right.
Yep, I'm back.
Hi, Ben. Again.
Yeah. So you found some things that I didn't even know that were. Yeah. It's just that they.
I push buttons.
And I push. Okay. So let's explain where. yes. Where we're at, which is. Okay, so life is a little interesting. The party, okay, let me close. Let me just get a couple of things going straight. Then let me see if I can get some maps up. And then we will... where are you? And then we are in new maps, and you're at the tip of pinch with grid preview. So, all right. So the brief overview. The party. The way the adventure started was everybody. What was approximately every 50 plus years, the Marazar have invaded the Kingdom of Greth for as long back as many people remember, farther back than many people can remember. It goes on for several hundred years. And it's every 50 years when a comet appears in the sky, the Marazar have been invading Greth. Most people don't know why. You don't know why they invade. So what happens is that 50 years ago, the king of Marazar was actually killed on the battlefield when a battalion of his bodyguard deserted, and the forces of Greth killed him. So everybody thought, oh, great, wonderful. We won't have any more problems with the Marazar. Well, this time, the 50 years rolled around, the comet appeared, and the Marazar invaded this time. But as because there wasn't as much expectation of that, the forces of Greth weren't quite as prepared. So they, at the very last minute, they drafted everyone they could, and you got sent down to a place called here, which was Camp Mangther. And then, anyway, some of the party were drafted, and then they found out the army that invading this time is very different from the Marazar of old. They're not dressed the same, they don't act the same, they don't actually even look much like the same. The majority of the forces are a little bit darker skinned than the previous. Forces, they came in, and the forces of Greth met them on the battlefield and lost terribly. And you were out on guard duty, and anyway, some of the party were out on guard duty, and when they came back, the Marazar had come by and slaughtered everyone. So the party's been wandering around trying to figure out what to do. They came up, there was a elven village that had been slaughtered. And then they came up here, and they came up here, and then they spent some time at this tower, and then they came up farther. They came into the town, and, oh, actually, I missed one. They went south down to this city, and then they ran away. And they came up to this town, and they ran away. They came over here.
And we do not run away. We walk strategically.
So we basically they've been wandering around.
They're wandering around. So I guess it was two adventures ago that you came up to the farmhouse of Ranella.
Ranella.
And last week you came up to Ranella's farmhouse. She's an old widow. She has who is a younger man who's living with her, and she has a relatively large two-story house. And she offered to, if you cleaned up the place, because it was getting a little run down, and you cleaned up the place, you've been catching geese and ducks and fixing dinner and cooking for them, for her. And then last week, Venu disappeared for a while, and you've had some interesting dealings with Venu. And then the party was in the home, and you heard the horns of the conch shell horns of the shogun, and they attacked. And you defeated the shogun who were attacking last week. But of course, in the attack, you used, I can't remember, it's something thunderclap, which gives this massive echoing thunder strike. And you killed the shogun along with that. And now at the end of last week, you heard more, in response to the thunderclap, of more shogun conch shell horns.
But I am in the bedroom with the lady of the house under the bed, all protected. And I'm going to, if I can, I would like to start by going through her drawers. Ha ha. And, yeah, not those ones.
But how do you know if she wears them?
Yeah, not those ones. I want to open up her bureau drawers, if I can, and look inside them while all this fun stuff is going on outside. You can figure out what's inside them after. Just give me good stuff.
Okay. So, what happened was that the shogun attacked, so you're in the larger room with Ranella. She was hiding under the bed, and anyway, I need to know. Okay, so let's. Let me. Okay, I should have done this before, but I didn't. Okay, on the first. All right. So we've got the party. There are, shall we say, on the second room, there is the basement of the house, there is the first floor of the house, and there is the second floor of the house. So we have got, let me...
Two people on the roof, two people on the main floor, and me in the bedroom on the main floor. Well, except
and
I'm not sure if
those two on the roof. There's a giant spider with the two people on the roof.
Oh, thank goodness it's on the roof. Okay.
On the widow's walk. Oh, okay. Wait a second. Okay, let me go down the list since I sort of got this. Where is Olrog? First, second, or tell me where you're at.
I'm on the third floor.
There's only two floors. There's
he's on the widow's walk with.
Oh, on the widow's walk. Okay, on the roof. Okay. Yes.
With
if
Dan
that's
and
where
Sajan.
Yeah,
Sajan. Oh yeah, Sajan. Hi, Sajan.
And then.
Hello.
Hi.
Oh, we have somebody else. Do we have somebody else?
Sajan. Michael.
Michael. Okay. Yeah. Oh, okay. Okay. I thought I heard somebody else's.
I think that was in his background.
That was somebody in the background saying hi.
Cat on the hot tin roof. So. Okay, so that's Olaf. Where's Krista?
in the bedroom with the lady watch.
Oh, okay. I'm in the bedroom all safe and secure with those doors closed and barred and the windows barred. And
okay.
So and like I said, I'm going to look through her drawers.
Where is Doug?
Doug is with Xanatar at the front door.
Okay, so you're on the first floor.
Yes.
First floor at front door. Okay, I gotta keep track of this. And Xanatar is on the first floor, the front door. And all right. And Sajan
and Pendel.
Yeah, we're out front.
Is with Penladan Moonstone and his giant spider, Alan. Oh, Alar. Alar the giant. Spike on the
2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm missing one. Who am I missing? Who am I missing? Oh, I got Jane. Okay, so
I can't mute. So. If...
Oh, okay. That's okay. 1 second here.
My device is being very slow.
So, so
I'm reading you off the names that I forgot to unmute. So I'm not much help, am I?
So John and Dan are where?
Should be on the Widow's Walk.
Dad, they're on the Widow's Walk with Olog. Unless Olog wants to be on the main floor with.
No, I'm good on the Widow's
Walk. Okay, on the Widow's Walk. Okay.
Just watch out for that thunderclap.
Yeah, Xanatar's down on the ground.
Sajan, Dan, and Alar, this giant...
Olog. Oh, you're spider, too. Don't forget his damn spider.
And Alar is spider, right?
Yeah, it's in the chat, all the stats and everything.
Okay, so where... It's in the chat... I don't see it.
Oh, yeah, in the previous chat.
Oh.
Yeah, the previous chat, the only one I have access to.
Oh, that's right, yeah, because you have... Yeah, okay, so that makes
life... One thing is, he still has to keep track of it, right?
Okay, well, let's see, where did I...
Did you say his name was Alar?
Olog.
No, the spider.
Alar. A-L-A-R.
Okay.
So, okay, giant wolf spider. Okay, we'll just put A-L-A-R. Oh, that's all I care about is A-L-A-R. A-L-A-R. All right, now, Alar is also on the Widow's Walk, right?
Yes.
Oh, okay. All right. So, okay. So, you hear the... you hear the conch shell horns. Okay. So you hear the conch shell horns. You decide to okay. That'll actually make sense.
I'm looking to see if I can find any of these spells that I think that person has been using on her.
So you've got people up watching on the... So what is Doug? Doug and Xanatar are on the first floor, right?
Yes.
Yep.
So tell me what you're doing.
Well, according to my notes, we're just waiting to see something to shoot at. That's what I'm doing.
And so you're watching toward the sea and so on, I guess, is the...
Yeah.
Okay. And
spider sense is tickling.
Because we've already dispatched a couple of these things.
And then he thunderclapped and a whole lot of crap happened. But you remember just as we were leaving?
Uh-huh.
Peek over your shoulders.
Okay. So, so Xanatar is doing the, and what, where is that, what is Xanatar doing?
I'm going to search the bodies of the ones that are already here.
You're going outside the house?
I was already outside the house. I ran up to them, thunderclapped them, killed them.
Okay, so you're, okay.
So he's not at the door, okay.
Okay. So, okay, so Krista is busy getting into Ranella's drawers.
But I am looking to see if I can find
everybody,
whatever.
And we've got, and we've got Sajan and Dan and Alar and Olog up on the Widow's Walk watching to the ocean for this and we have Doug is watching out the I guess out the windows to see if any more Shrogan come up. Correct?
Yeah, I'm kind of peeking out the front door.
Okay,
a little cover.
Peeking out
yeah.
the front door. Okay, so so Doug, give me a perception check.
Okay. That's a six.
Okay. Okay. So, out of the corner of your eye, you see Sajan coming up behind you, and you hear him saying, "You see anything?" You're looking out, and then Sajan. Attacks you from behind as a surprise. What's your armor class?
16.
Oh, man.
Yeah, you bet. I'll attack him. All right. This is cool.
Okay, so...
I didn't know I was doing that.
He misses... He swings at you and misses twice. And, so what does, what do you do?
Push him down.
First response is to punch him in the face.
Give me a roll.
Hey, man, don't do that.
So 12?
Miss? Okay.
What's going on, man?
So then, since everybody else is still watching outside, he had, man, I can't believe I've rolled a 2, a 3, a 4. Now then,
good, you're getting my rolls.
What's your armor class?
16.
Oh, okay. Finally, he hits for 8. Damage.
Okay.
So, it's your reaction. What do you do now?
Can I shoot him?
Sure.
I have a feeling this is not Sinjon. Okay. Oh, man. 11?
Miss? And he goes again. So everybody else is sort of watching for the shogun. Meanwhile,
hey guys, we got a problem here.
Okay, so you finally announced something, but okay. Okay. 12? What's your armor class?
16.
Okay, misses there. But the other one, 12 plus hits for 7.
Okay.
Cool. All right.
Can I now, do a listen now. Check for the scuffle?
Ranella is under the bed. While Krista's searching through the drawers, Ranella comes out of the bed and says, "What are you doing? Aren't you worried that they'll come and get us?"
Yes, that's why I'm looking to see if I can find anything that will help us in this instance. Is there anything in here that we can use? Maybe that I can, use a spell, make a spell out of?
Maybe, says, have you seen Venu? I'm worried about him. I mean, I don't know what I would do without him. You know.
I think I saw him in hiding in the back room.
Back room.
Before we came in here.
Venu's not the kind of person. I've never seen him hide from anything. He doesn't.
Oh, then maybe he wasn't hiding.
He's so much like my husband before he died. In fact, he looks just exactly like what my husband did when he was a young man. Anyway, so you hear the conch horns coming closer, and now I guess so Dan hollered. So what does everybody else do?
First, did I find anything?
And we'll get back to you in a minute. And then the rest of the people up on the Widow's Walk. Zenitar, are you still outside searching through? So Zenitar, as you're searching the dead bodies, you find some oyster shells that have been on the inside are scratched with symbols, shall we say?
I will collect them then.
Okay. So there's symbols on the inside, and you're really not exactly sure what that is, as we'll get into that. So Zenitar, you find that they're there, and you also find that they have pearls. We'll figure that out in a minute. So that's Zenitar. So Zenitar is collecting that, and then it is now. Who was it? It was Doug. So what is Doug doing?
Oh, I'm going to step outside and holler to Zenitar. Dude, I need some help. And then take another shot at what I believe is Vanu.
Okay.
That's a total of 22.
Okay, you hit.
For 9 damage.
Okay, one second. So,
And if Zenitar runs up, I tell him that's not Sejin.
One second here. No, come on. Why? Sometimes. Number scaling. So you hit him for 9, right?
Yes.
So, okay, so he... takes swings at you. Okay, and what's your armor class?
16.
Hit and
I am back. Yay.
Welcome back. I'm getting my butt kicked.
17?
Oh, that hits. That hits.
What?
That hits.
Yes. So, okay. So John, okay, so that's there. At this point, let's sort of roll initiative to figure out what people are doing. How's that sound?
All right, Dan has a 24.
Okay.
Doug has 13.
Okay. What about Olog?
12.
12. Krista?
13.
13. Xanatar?
19.
Sajan? 19. That's Michael. You're muted. And then Alar? Does Alar? Let's see.
Usually, if it's a, he gets a role as well.
Yeah. So John, I need Sajan and Alar. Let's see.
So that's Ben. Give your spider.
Ben, give your spider, and Michael, if you're muted. Okay, well...
Alar has a 9 overall.
Okay. And Michael, are you here? We'll try going once, going twice. Michael gets a 1. He goes last. Okay. Dan, what do you do?
All right. What do I see?
What you hear are some conch shell horns. You hear the conch shell horns coming closer, and you heard some sort of scuffle from downstairs.
All right. Then I'm gonna go, leaving Alar upstairs to keep watch, because he has his spider abilities.
Okay.
So I'm going to run downstairs and see what's going on.
Okay, so we'll do there. Xanatar, who is looting bodies.
If I don't see any danger, I'm going to keep collecting my swag.
Well, you heard someone sort of hollering for help.
Vaguely on the winds.
Okay.
I'm assuming that... I don't. Well, for one, I've never even been up on the crow's nest. I don't know how to get up there. And two, that's like, you know, basically 3 stories up in the air.
Okay. Well, actually, it's only up 1 story. It's sort of like a walkway on the second. I guess it is on the 3rd floor. Yeah.
I'll just shout out at the general direction of the house that, you know, somebody needs to go up on the roof. Help this dude out.
Okay.
Aren't there 2 people on the roof?
There were 2 on the roof, yes. There were Sajan and Dan and Alar.
I'm up there, too.
Yeah. No, there
oh,
was...
Yeah, oh, oh, yeah, that's
Olog.
Right.
So there's 3 people up there.
Yeah.
So and Dan came down.
So Krista... so Ranella says... Do you really think that they'll get in here?
No. Nope. I don't. I think we're perfectly safe. I think as long as we remain in here, we're safe. Is there a secret exit maybe we could learn about? So as if, you know, if we want to get outside?
Welcome.
Hi, William.
Oh, okay. So this... Okay, so... All right.
Jet Li's here.
Okay, so now then... All right, so let me add one more to my...
Never going to find out what's in this room.
Gently. All right. So we'll put that there. This gets... Okay. So now then... Character... Light Jet Li... Okay, get over here. We'll put and we will put, sorry, 1 second, get Jet Li is last. We'll figure out where Jet Li does, and we'll figure out where he's, we'll assume Jet Li's upstairs asleep or something like that. So because we're coming into there, so we just got through, Krista was there, so we're back to Doug at the front. So what does Doug do?
Oh, hell no. No. I asked if there was a freaking secret room. She's either got to tell me yes or no, and you got to tell me if I found anything.
Okay.
Please.
Okay. As you've been searching through her... drawers. Okay, so
she is a tiny lady. I remember that. Her drawers are very small.
So yes. Oh, come on, where did that? Where? Now I can't find things. What happened? I'm sorry, I'm having a tiny bit of a problem. What happened to where I was at? I've lost...
I'm back.
Sorry, I'm having a bit of a...
Welcome back. That's okay, you can tell me after if it's mine, if I'm the holdup.
I might have to do some chatting if my connection drops out a little bit.
Farmhouse. And all my stuff disappeared. A part of my adventure disappeared. Just the second here.
I've been down that road before.
No, it's...
Shut down and restart.
No, what happened is that...
Does that mean I could roll a new character up?
No, it's... no, let me get back here.
Maybe.
Let me get... Where did the...
You're still sharing if you want to stop sharing.
I know, but what happened is that all my descriptions of the... of...
Go to recycle bin.
Well, I did. Did I take care of anybody when I was?
I don't know what happened.
While you look, I'm gonna go see if I can get something to eat.
Sorry, I'm just literally my. All the description disappeared. Shit. I apologize because it's the okay. I can go on. No, there it is. There it is. Ah, I apologize. It was just...
No problem. Tech happens, man.
Yeah. So, anyway... There we go. Now, it was just... Okay. Things were just getting a little paranoid because I had part of this that was getting... So, Krista... Krista stepped away. So we'll continue back where we were at. And that was Doug. What does Doug do?
Doug is going to continue to fire at...
Was it Strahan?
Whoever.
So...
Yeah, I think he's attacking me. Some version
that's
of
that's another me. 22.
Okay.
And that's another 9 damage.
Okay. That's Doug Olog.
Just a quick, is it daylight or?
It's night.
It's night. Okay. And do I hear or see anything outside?
You hear the conch shell horns. They're Shoggin conch shell horns. You heard them in response to the thunderclap, and you hear off in the distance some sort of sound of feet.
My spider has dark vision.
Yeah.
But because Olar would be next. So you don't see anything. They're a little bit too far off.
Well,
you see some movement in the distance toward the ocean.
Is that away from us or towards us?
It's coming towards you. Okay. The ocean is to the west. You're on the west coast here, so.
I'm gonna scream out so everyone else, you know, can hear that people something's inbound with this. And I'm going to get my shortbow ready.
Okay.
Ready to go, but I'm just going to wait.
So we got Alar is looking and is honestly there. And so then...
Yeah, he's just chittering happily because he's getting ready to fight.
Okay, so now the creature attacks again. Oh.
But no, don't mess this up.
8 points of damage.
To who?
Isn't it Doug? Yeah, who we've been...
Okay, yeah. So I only had 7 left, so I'm at 0.
Okay, so you went to 0. Okay. All right. So we'll get to the... to Doug. All right. Now then, It's Sir John's turn. Sir John?
The real one or the fake one?
Michael Lingfield? Lingfield? Michael?
He said his connection was being spotty, so he might have to do his chat thing to talk.
Okay. Is there anything you're going to do, or what?
Hello? I stepped away for a second.
Oh, okay, yeah. So, Michael, go ahead. So what happens is that, what do you want to do right now?
Michael, you are, sorry, Sajan, you need to heal Doug. Find her.
Well, he doesn't know that Doug is down.
No, and he's also up on the Widow's Walk, and he's muted.
Nobody heard me hollering.
Well, they heard you, but
Dan's right there.
Dan was okay. Yeah, that's true. Dan was okay. Dan was right there. That's right. Dan ran down, and so then we'll get to Dan in a minute. But we'll get there. But it's, so now it's Sir John's turn. We get Sir John, Jet Li, and then we get back to Dan. So what is
Oh, Michael's back again.
Yeah, I'm back.
Okay, so what do you do?
And he's gone again.
Okay. So we'll skip over to John. Jet Li was upstairs asleep in one of the bedrooms and heard the commotion. And now what does Jet Li do?
After one of those thunderclaps, he slept.
That's what woke him up. But he's a slow waking up from... So he's upstairs on the second floor just waking up. So where does Jet Li... What is...
So I need to go outside then and see what the commotion's about, or we are all inside.
Okay, you're up on the second floor, just coming out of the room, and there's commotion outside and that. Now we get back to Dan. Dan ran downstairs, and you see... So John sort of, shall we say, do a coup de grace on Doug.
And I just left Sir John.
So what does Dan do?
I'm going to draw back and release an arrow into that fake.
Okay. So go ahead.
All right, I got a 19 to hit. Longbow is a D8. Oh, I'm paused. All right. What do I add to that? All right, I did 12 damage.
Okay. He's bloodied. Xanatar, still outside. You hear things approaching, and you see some creatures coming out of the darkness. So.
And it's nighttime, yeah.
Yeah.
Are they still a distance from me?
They're at long distance right now, yes.
Okay, so they might not see me yet, right?
That's great.
Okay, so in that case, I will cast... Oh, I just had it. Wait, I have the wrong one. Sorry, give me one second. I will cast Spike Growth in a 20-foot radius between us, closest to me. It creates a 20-foot radius centered on a point within range, which is up to 150 feet. Twists and sprouts hard spikes and thorns. Actually, they're at long range, so I could just cast it like centered on them. Are they closer than 150 feet, or are they about that?
They're about that. Okay. They're closing, yeah.
So the area becomes difficult terrain for the duration. When a creature into or within the area, it takes 2d4 piercing damage for every 5 feet it travels. Transformation of the ground is camouflaged to look natural. Any creature that can't see the area at the time of the spell is cast must make a wisdom perception check against my spell save DC to recognize the terrain as hazardous before entering it.
Okay. So, Xanatar does that. Krista, okay, back to Krista. What you found in her, that's what was causing me a bit of contortion when I couldn't find things, was you found, when you were going through her drawers, you found this silver ring was wrapped up in some fine cloth that there was it was like wrapped up in a little pack, like a little package, and you see a silver ring with an obsidian with the carved into the, like a cartouche into the symbol of a warhammer into the it's not a warhammer, it's a regular it's a laborer's hammer. Laborer's hammer in the carpenter or somebody, but it's a hammer on the thing, and Ranella, when she sees that you've found that, she goes, do you know what that is?
I actually don't.
You're not a member of the group.
I do not think so.
Oh,
I would remember that.
Here, let me. This is. Let me put that away.
Okay, so, I give it back to her and remember where she puts it. And
okay, so she puts it back in the drawer and she says, if we have to, there is a way out.
Good. Okay. Do I find any other spells or scrolls or anything while I'm looking?
No.
Okay. While the rest of the while she's hiding under the bed and that, I'm going to concentrate on detect magic to see if I can find the exit.
Okay.
That'll take like 3 turns, so.
Okay. So you're busy doing that. Okay. So let's get back to this party. Okay. So now then, okay, Doug gets to make his first death saving throw.
By the way, she should have let us clean this room. It's awful dusty.
Okay, so Doug, make your first death saving throw.
What do I roll for that again?
Just a d20.
Okay. I got a 12.
Get better than a 10. Yay!
Okay, so that's a positive save. Okay. Now, Olog.
Yes.
So, what does Olog do?
Okay, are they within, how close are they to us? You said about 150 feet still?
They're about 120 feet, I guess. They're coming closer, but Xanatar cast a spell out there, so.
I'm just waiting at this point. I don't have anything that I can hit with.
Okay. And I guess Alar is going to do the same.
Yeah, since I don't know what he can do, I just know his skills, I just don't know what to do.
So, it was Dan who came down the steps to see what was going on with Olog. So what happens is, so John rushes Dan and attacks Dan. And what's your armor class? Good God.
17.
Two misses. I cannot believe I have rolled this many rolls below 5.
Welcome to my world.
Okay. So he misses twice on Dan. Now, it's Xanatar's turn.
Okay, does it seem like I might find anything else on these bodies, or have I picked them clean?
Well, they have, obviously they have weapons, if you're interested in weapons, but no. Weapons and such. So, they are Shogun, you've got some pearls, and you've got these oyster shells with carvings on them. So there are you realize trying to roll what you got for treasure, and I'm rolling just as bad for that as I am on the hits. You know, it's like, oh, how many pearls do you find? I roll a 1. So not only does it affect, you know, the hits, but I am rolling, really, that is a 20-sided die. Yeah, okay, that is a 20-sided die. Okay, we'll say you find 5 pearls. because I go, yeah, how many do you find? I roll a d20. I roll a 1. We'll give you 5. So you
and
find
Sage is ready to fight.
What? What?
Sage, Michael can't talk because it slows down his connection way too much, but he's okay. Is listening to the broadcast.
Okay. So that was Xanatar. It's Krista. Krista's casting a magic spell.
Yeah, which I'm just wandering around her room, just thinking about the room, and she can talk to me. I can talk to her.
Okay, so you're talking girl things, and she's telling you just how wonderful Vanu has been with her.
And I'm nodding and smiling at her, and my mind is totally going, where the hell's the magic?
Okay. So Doug gets to make his next saving throw.
That is a 15.
So you've got two saves, two good, okay. Olog.
Okay. About how far are they out now?
They've been closing in, but the what was the Xanatar? Noah, what does the what? How did that slow them down?
It's difficult terrain, and they take some sort of piercing damage.
Okay, difficult terrain, so it slowed them down.
2d4 for every, like, so many feet.
Yeah, sorry. It's taking me a struggle to get my stupid mute button off. Okay, yeah, it's difficult terrain. It creates the 20-foot radius or circle. And for every 5 feet that they travel through it, they take 2d4 piercing damage.
2d8 piercing damage. Okay.
D4. I apologize.
2d4 piercing damage. Okay. So.
If they go all the way through it, of course, that would be 20 feet. So they'd have to roll 8d4 damage total.
Okay. So let me put. Okay. So. So 8d4, so that's 2.5 times 8. Okay. So, do I even have, I know I probably have that many d4s, but we'll, okay, give me an 8, give me 8d4 and tell me what you got. Or do you want me to, well, or I could roll it. Let's see, I got 1, 2, 3, here's 4d4.
I'm not certain with how you've been rolling.
Okay, 3, 6, 7, 9 plus another. That's 9 plus 9, 10, 12, 15, 19 points of damage. Okay. All right. So what happens is what's coming out of the dark are five bloodied shogun. So Olog can see five shogun coming out of the darkness, and they're a bit bloodied from coming through the that. So go ahead. So what does Olog do?
I'm gonna start shooting at him.
Okay, give me a shot.
19.
It's a hit.
And I'm assuming we have advantage over them.
Yeah.
And that's 10 damage.
Oh, that one's dead. Okay. Now, what does Alar do? He sees some prey.
All right. Let me look at his character sheet real quick, because it's weird what he does. I'm not entirely certain. So far, all he has is bite.
So okay,
he's going to wait till they're nice and close.
Okay, okay. So we'll hold off this round.
Yep, he's going to hold.
Okay, so now then, we have... So John attacking Dan again. Another 2, but also a 20.
The 20 hits.
Yeah, the 20 hits. And so that's double damage, right? Yeah, so... Eighteen?
Ouch.
I guess I'm dead.
Oh, no. No, that was on Dan. Doug, you haven't... We haven't got to you yet.
Yeah, I'm bloodied.
You're bloodied. Xanatar has right. Now...
I will close a bit more range with them, and after doing so, I will now cast Gust of Wind to knock them all back into the spikes.
Oh. Okay.
All right, so it's a 60-foot long, 10-foot wide blast. Starts in my direction. They have to make a strength saving throw. Or be pushed 15 feet away from me.
Okay, so a strength saving throw. Okay. So, okay, it's... What's the DC on the strength?
16.
16.
Oh, wait, sorry, 17. It's a second level spell.
17. Okay. So, one saves... And the rest get pushed back in, and they would take how much damage? Or they'd take that next time, right?
I don't know. That's actually up to you, because the spell description does say that when they pass through a 5-foot section and they get blown 15 feet into it.
So, okay, so they get blown into it. So we'll, okay, so we'll see. They take normally just 1d4, or is it, what is it for one round?
It's 2d4 per 5 feet.
2d4 per...
So that would be 64 per 15 feet.
64 for... Okay. Okay, so you... That killed just the... Even if I rolled ones, 64 killed four more of them. One of them is alive. Okay. That's Xanatar. Krista?
Okay, this is now round two. I'm still wandering around her room, touching stuff, looking for spells, scrolls, or an exit, or any magic that might glow in the dark.
Okay.
If she's getting a... Because is it... would we have, like, light candle or something in the room?
Do
would that, like, be normal? Okay. Yeah. Okay. She's not afraid of the dark, then I don't have to cast anything. Okay.
Yeah, and she closed the shutters, but it was, yeah, light, you've got light. So now then, it's Doug. It makes his death saving throw.
That's a 14.
Okay, so Doug is stabilized at, does he get to 1 or is it 0? I can't remember. It's somewhere. You're stable. You don't
stabilized at 0, and she has to get her next one to get 1.
Okay, so there's that. That's Doug. So you're stable at 0. Olog!
And St. John is ready to fight. He just, like I said, speaking kicks him off, but he is ready to play.
Okay. So, Olog, what does Olog do?
I turn to, I believe it's Alar, and ask him, should we capture that last guy? He's coming
out. Alar is just going to chitter at you, because he's a spider. A giant wolf spider.
That's cool. That means he's a good member of the team because we're not racist so, here. It doesn't matter to us.
You can shoot at the creature.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Okay.
18.
Hit.
And 4 damage.
Dead. Okay, so the shotgun are dead. So that was Olog. Alar just sitting up there looking.
Yep, he's doing his lookout thing, making sure there's no more enemies coming into range.
Okay.
He does have 60 feet of dark vision.
And Sajan attacks Dan. Okay. And with an 18 and a 19?
Both hit. I fear I'm going to be unconscious soon.
14?
Yep, I'm unconscious. I had 7. So okay. As I go down, I give a holler out, Alar! Who will immediately come to my aid with 40 speed.
Okay.
Straight down the wall, because he has that.
Not if he hits you into unconsciousness before you yelled it. Just before
you yelled. Give me a d20 roll, and we'll see.
All right, give me a sec. Ha ha, 17.
Okay, so you got it off. Okay, so Alar will be coming down. Alright. Now then, it's Sajan. Okay, so he can't...
Yeah, it's all in the chat.
Let's see, Sajan, where does it... Okay, it's a different chat, I think.
No, it's the other way. It's the window that you call us to it in. But if you've closed it, then you can't. Just tell him what he can do, and somebody else will read it to you.
Yeah, that's what I'm doing.
So I have to get here. I closed it because I just closed it. Okay, so...
I think he was casting flee, but if I understand correctly, there's nothing. Everything's dead.
Okay. I sense it.
He wants to do a perception check for battle sounds, See if he hears the battle going on downstairs.
Okay. Give me a roll. There we go. Oh. If you close the window, it closes. That's okay. Yeah, sometimes I tell it pop out, but then it doesn't. So give.
He has a short lag because he's watching it through YouTube, I think. Either that. I don't know. He just said he's willing to play this way.
Okay, yeah. So just roll. Just, if you can, give me a roll. An attack roll. Or a perception roll. Yes. So this is... Yes, there are weird ways to...
He says he rolled a 20.
Okay. So you hear... he hears something, so what happens is he can come... He can come down. Okay, so... he can come down and try and investigate. All right. Now then... So that's a John. Jet Li! What does Jet Li do?
Alright, so I believe now things are coming more clear. So Chris is trying to find some kind of secret thing that allows her to go downstairs for this battle, so we're separated? Or is it just so pitch dark we can't see? I guess I'm trying to figure out where Sajan and Doug are
okay.
In relation to me.
I'm stuck in the back bedroom. Do you remember this house at all?
No, we stopped and okay. I wasn't here last episode.
Okay, this house is not a basement, or not a basement, a main floor. I'm pushed into the back bedroom that actually faces the water with the lady of the house that we're trying to, well, that we think we need to protect. And she's barred all the doors in the room and the windows. So I'm in there. You guys are all out there fighting these guys.
Gotcha. I ran downstairs to see the commotion, but it was dark. So I got the impression with the things coming out of the water, we were outside. Somewhere outside where it's dark. But we also, with the perception check, or at least I believe John was looking... Sajan and Doug are battling each other, or possibly why this?
You're not really sure.
Okay, I understand. Okay, but okay.
So you heard a noise downstairs, like battle.
Okay, but I want to get to them. I just have to figure out how to properly get to them, or is there a challenge between me getting to them?
No, you can just come downstairs.
Okay. And then what do I see?
Okay. So, what do you see? All right. So, give me a... okay, so you're just coming downstairs to investigate, right?
Yes.
Okay. So...
I was woken up, and I was just trying to figure out, after hearing everyone got killed from what was coming out of the water, or what, you know, they had been done, but why Doug went down. And now, you know, so I'm just trying to figure out who's...
And Dan went down.
And Dan went down.
Okay. So, as you come down the stairs... You see three bodies lying at the lying just inside the doorway. You see Dan, you see Doug, and you see Sajan all lying on the floor, bloody. What do you do?
Okay, well, I guess I'm trying to equal a perception to see if I can take some kind of understanding or resemblance of what's going on in my immediate vicinity and if there's a danger or threat.
So you see three bodies of people on the floor in...
Do I need to speak louder?
Izzy, you're not laughing.
Okay. So...
Okay, I'm speaking louder!
What about, Okay, so I want to check the bodies. I mean, obviously I know they're my friends.
Which one are you going to check first?
So, but I can see that they're bloodied, but unresponsive. Who just went down? Dan just went down last, right? Because Doug was already down. So I'm going to take Dan.
Okay. As you... Okay. So that's Jet Li. So Dan gets to make his first death saving throw.
Well, I just got a 20, so I know I made that first one.
Okay, so you're actually stable at one hit point. So if you roll a 20, you actually are stable. So you actually are at one hit point.
Doesn't he go to because he was at zero? Doesn't and that gives you 2 points, so like or not 2 points, but 2 levels. He goes to too good and to stable, which is zero.
No, okay.
I'm just asking if that's how it works.
Okay. He's stable, he can't die, but he doesn't gain HP until he's healed or does something to actually wake up.
No, I think... Okay.
That's what
I thought. Let me get there. I think it's like around 197, if I remember correctly. This is the... Okay.
Okay.
When you make a death saving throw, if you roll a 20 on a d20, you regain one hit point. So he rolled a 20. That was a natural 20, not with any bone. Yeah, it's a natural 20. So you actually revive to one hit point.
So I can talk?
You're... We'll get your... That's your action for this one. So you're at one hit point. So Dan is at one hit point. Doug is stable at zero. And that was Jet Li. So Dan is there. Now it's Xanatar. What does Xanatar do?
Isn't it Dan's spider's turn?
We did the spider because it was... We did the spider, but the spider goes actually before the creature. So we went with... It's Olog, Alar, the creatures, Sajan, Jet Li. We just did Dan. It's now Xanatar. And then it will be Krista. And then
So I don't see any dudes left alive, do I?
You don't see any... you don't see any more Shogun, and you don't hear any more noises, yes.
Okay, so I'm going to leave both spells intact, and I'm going to take off back to the house to see if I can help.
Okay. So you're coming up to there. Krista, you just finished... I guess it would be in the third round. You had just finished casting your Detect Magic. You detect magic in the dresser where the ring was. You don't see any... And you also see... detect some magic underneath the dresser.
Okay. Did she put the ring back in the same dresser I took it out of?
Yes.
Okay.
So that was in the top drawer of the dresser was where the ring was. So you detect magic there, but you also get an aura of magic. You know, the dresser's is up on little feet, and you detect magic down, like, underneath the dresser.
Okay. Okay, right. I'm not going to let on that I see that. I'm just going to nod, note it, and continue dealing with this lady waiting, you know, for to shoot some magic.
So now it's Olog, is turn. So what does Olog do?
I'm going to stay on the roof. And, okay. Do I hear or see anything? Or is it quiet? Or...
It seems fairly quiet. Now we've got Alar comes down the stairs. Okay, give me... What's Alar's intelligence? Okay, they pasted it. Was it pasted here?
Doesn't it have to be two or less?
I don't know, because it doesn't say it.
Okay, medium. Okay, it's a giant wolf spider. Okay, yep. So... giant... Do they make a separate or giant wolf spider? Giant wolf spider, page 330. Okay? So, just for ha-has, okay, so it's page 330 of the Monster Manual. Armor class 13, hit points 11, strength 12, dex 16, constitution 13, intelligence 3, wisdom 12, charisma... perception plus three. Okay.
So he's an ugly SOB.
He's an ugly SOB. So what happens is that the giant wolf spider needs to make an intelligence check on... make an intelligence check to because you think your master is dead.
All right. What's the modifier for that? Intelligence modifier?
Minus four.
All right. Overall, 12.
So you rolled a 12. Okay.
No, I rolled a 16, but the modifier of minus four.
Okay. So he doesn't think his... Master is dead, but okay, so this, but he doesn't perceive any danger at this point. Because there are three dead bodies laying on the floor, and so he would come over to his master and sort of, you know, nudge his master. Now then... So John, who was it that came down? Okay, so Dan is down. Who just
say
came
John
down?
John came down.
What? So John came hey, John's, down.
Yeah, he said he came down.
So John came down, and there's so John lying on the floor. So what?
Jet Li just came down and was
okay,
looking at
okay,
the body.
So there's Jet Li and so John both came down. Okay, yeah. So, while you're... As they come down, Sir John leaps up from the ground and attacks Sir John.
Good, now you know it's not you.
And that so, spider has a reaction to that.
Okay,
He sees...
No, because it's... You, no.
Not his turn?
No. 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 No.
Okay. Okay. Okay.
Because but reaction.
What happens is the creature would have known before you did that. So...
I was going to have him do his move since he just came down so that he could do his thing, but if you say no, then no it is.
No. Because he could read your thoughts. So
but he wouldn't have read any thoughts because it wasn't him. So when the spider jumped, or when the person jumped up, that's when he would have reacted because he would have either sensed something or it moved, so a spider would jump.
So but you're saying you, that Well, we rolled the intelligence for the monster for the spider, and the spider didn't detect anything. He thought that they were all down and dead, so we'll go with that.
But spiders react to moving things.
But okay, then give me. Okay, we've already rolled initiative. Okay, I'm going to go with this one.
A telepathic link?
What?
They share a telepathic link?
No, I don't think they do.
I have Beast Mastery, which gives me a Beast Companion.
Yeah, it's just a companion.
If there's no telepathic link, then I would say that spiders don't really have any other extraordinary other than their eyesight and their web sense, and that's about it. So it would have no way of distinguishing these apart.
So, yeah. So what happened? Yeah, so the spider, we'll just continue with the stuff. So the creature, the Sajan that was laying down, jumps up and attacks Sajan, and what's Sajan's armor class?
17, he said, up in the chat.
Oh, okay. So that's two hits. For 17 against Sajan? So, so that's 17. Okay, so now it's Sajan's turn.
He sent that when he gets there, he's going to close and give the fake a mace to the face and then heal any downed characters, but he was just attacked, so I don't know if that's what he wants to do still or not.
Okay, so so give me a roll to hit. So okay, roll for me. Roll for you. Okay, I will. All right. Roll. A 13 plus. What's your bonus? So, anybody know what?
I think straight means the modifier, so he's just 13.
Just a 13? No straight? Oh, okay. You miss. I mean, he had armor class of 14, so I thought you would have at least a plus one modifier. Ooh. Okay, so Sajan misses Sajan. Jet Li, you see Sajan fighting Sajan. What do you do?
I can distinguish between which one was the first aggressor and which one was Sajan with the mace.
Well, one of them is the first. The aggressor appears to be bloodied.
There's an arrow sticking out of his back.
Having seen Sajan miss with the mace, the one.
Yeah, so.
I'm not going to grapple that one, but I'm going to grapple the other one.
Oh, well, okay. Let's do this. Give me a DC 10, no, DC 5 intelligence check.
Okay. Straight up, so that is a 7.
Okay. Close. If you had rolled like a 1, then, you know, you'd have got the wrong, going after the wrong one, which would have been hilarious. Okay, so go ahead.
All right, that's a natural 20 plus 4, 24 for my strength versus your dex or strength.
Okay, that's a hit.
No, that was a grapple. I want to grab and restrain.
Grab and restrain. Okay, you grapple.
Okay. So you just have to beat a 24 on your dex or strength, whatever better stat you he has.
Oh, okay, so he has to roll. Oh,
rolled a 16.
Okay, so he's grappled and has no movement. Disadvantage if he tries to do anything, I believe, and or he can choose to break out on his turn.
Okay, but we'll get to that one. So that's Jet Li's. So, Dan Pendleton. Okay.
Yes.
Dan is at one hit point.
Right.
So, what do you do?
On that monster manual, does it say that my spider can spin web?
Okay. Giant wolf spider.
Because I don't have any books. That's why I'm asking.
Okay. Giant wolf spider. Let's see. Actions, biting. Okay, spider climb.
What I shared is all I have.
Blind sight perception, spider climb, web sense. When in contact with the web, it says by webbing. Okay. What happens? Smaller than a giant spider, giant wolf spider hunts prey across open ground or hides in burrows or crevices or in a hidden cavity beneath the. Cavity beneath the debris. They really don't spin a web.
Okay, so I was gonna have him tie him up, but since he can't do anything, he's just gonna stand there.
I thought giant wolf spiders shot, like they jumped around, but they shot with a web when they wanted to.
Not in D&D.
Okay.
In real life, yes, but not in D&D.
They bite with poison additive.
Okay.
Yeah, and I don't want to kill him. We want to find out who he is and why he's doing what he's doing.
Okay, so...
So I'm just going to stand up and ask him, who are you? Though I do have a pretty good I have a pretty good idea who it is, but I want to make sure. See if he admits to it.
So okay, that's Jet Li's action there. We will get to
Dan's action.
Oh, that was Dan's action.
Yes.
Okay, Dan's action. At this point, Xanatar walks in. And what does Xanatar do?
Okay, so I see these two fighting. Right?
Well, you see Sajan. Well, okay. You see Jet Li grappling a bloody Sajan, and you see a Sajan standing there, and you see Dan is standing there too, and Dan is all bloodied. You see Doug lying on the floor.
Okay, so. I will look to the nearest piece of furniture.
Yeah.
What would I see?
A chair.
Okay, and how far is it from this dude?
It's... Okay, there's a chair... Well, there's a chair and a vase right... and a table right inside the doorway, I guess, would be the way to describe that.
Is it within, like, 5 feet of them, or is it further than that?
Within 5 feet, yeah.
Okay, so then I will cast Druid Craft on the vase, and I'll make the scent of sea elf come out of the vase.
The scent of what?
Sea elf. Yes, sea elf. They're the like notorious enemies of the Sagan.
Okay. Oh. Okay. Come out of the vase. Okay, all right. So, okay, that's Xanatar. So what does Krista do?
I'm still in the room. We're still nice and protected. Nobody lets me fight. We're going to stay put.
Okay.
Doug is at zero. Olog?
All right. Is there any way off the Widow's Walk to the outside, or do I have to go through the house?
You have to go through the house. You could jump. It's only
Because you can jump 30 feet ground.
Not 30 feet. It's the Widow's Walk is.
Well, that would be on the third level, and most houses at that time would have had 10-foot ceilings, I think.
Well, yeah, I guess it would be. Yeah, there would be an attic, so it would. Yeah, okay. So go ahead.
No, I'll go through the house to the outside.
Okay, so you'll go through the house down the stairs, and you see the grouping downstairs. Okay, so you
thump down the stairs.
And then we have Alar. So what does Alar do?
Alar's going to obey his last command and just stand there, okay, making sure this fake don't move.
Okay. Now then, what happens here? That's interesting. All right. So, okay, let's do it. Let's do that. Oh, okay. So, Jet Li is grappling the Sejon, and Sejon, even though you're grappled, grapple means that they can't move, but they can still attack. So he's
at disadvantage.
At disadvantage. Okay, so we'll do. Okay, so you do the low roll there. That's a 4. That's a miss. And the low roll there, which would be 11. 11 plus. What's your armor class?
Jet Li's armor class. You're attacking me.
Jet Li, yeah.
Armor class 15.
Okay, he hits with the second one for 9.
Okay.
So that's that one. It is now Sejon's turn.
He wants to cast a command spell, sleep, upon his fake.
Okay. Now then. So that's a command spell. So what does that affect? Let me look up sleep.
He's typing.
Sleep. So
if you know what page it's on, tell us what page we can.
276.
Oh, sorry, I wasn't asking you. Actually, I was saying somebody could tell you, but if you already know.
So, is he casting the first level sleep, I'm assuming?
That's what it says, command spell sleep.
Is it, okay, command, there is a sleep, which is a first level enchantment, and yeah. Or is it a command spell?
Are you doing sleep or command?
It's a command spell, and he's saying sleep.
Gotcha, so wisdom saving.
Command, okay. Command, which is the first level. So.
13.
Okay, so speak one word command that you can see in the range. Wisdom saving throw.
There's approach, drop, flee, grovel, halt. Okay, we'll say you on its next turn. So you do a command spell, so he gets a wisdom saving throw. Yeah, he saves. So, okay. So that's... who was that that did that? John. Then it's Jet Li's turn.
Well, I'm going to maintain my grapple. And... Yeah, I'm going to maintain grapple.
Okay. All right. So, Dan, what does Dan do?
Let me see. I think I have rope. I'm just checking to make sure. Yep, I have rope. So I'm going to walk over and tie his hands together.
Okay, you're going to... Okay. Xanatar? Xanatar? Noah?
Yeah, sorry. My computer's just running slow. It's hard to take the mute off. Okay, so one of the guys has pinned the other one, or was it the spider that pinned him?
The monk. Jet Li. Oh, okay. I just noticed that okay, so let me... Okay, this is a different campaign, so do you have a different character, Archie?
Yes, I do have a different character in mine here. I'm still working over. It's an old legacy game that character that I'm trying to cut back down to a first level to make it playable with y'all.
Okay, we'll put you in after we finish this combat, okay? How's that sound?
Not a problem, I can wait.
Okay, so
I didn't want to break up the... I didn't want to break...
Okay, so Xanatar, what does Xanatar do?
So, who has who pinned?
Jet Li has
the evil
Sajan.
And what's the other Sajan doing?
The other Sajan was what was he doing? He attacked last time, I think. He attacked Sajan.
Okay, so I'll eat my good berries and stand back and watch the comments go.
Krista?
I think it's busy playing San Andreas.
No, that's on my end.
Uh-huh, there you go. Now, I am going to remain in the room with the lady and keep talking to her. Is she telling me anything interesting or important as I'm speaking with her? Is she getting more comfortable with me? Or is she getting more agitated because what's-his-name isn't back?
She's agitated and she's wondering what all the noise outside. She's worried that, you know, that they will damage her house or, you know, or things will break in, but she says nothing's come close to this. So we'll go on there. Doug is still stable at zero. Olog, what does Olog do?
I'm now headed outside towards the enemies that we killed before to retrieve my arrow.
Okay. And Alar?
Everybody just keeps stepping over Doug.
Alar?
Alar is going to go and knock on the door where the girls are hiding and then walk back out to me.
Okay. Now then, let me see what this thing does. Okay.
The bloody Sir John changes his face, changes to Venu, and he, because he can, will attack Jet Li again. No, he will attack. He's got two attacks. He'll attack one on Dan and one on Jet Li. So the first one, okay, and both are at disadvantage. So the first one on Dan is a 5. That's a miss. And the second one on Jet Li is a 2, and that's a miss. Okay. So now we've got Venu there, and now it is Sir John, and you see Venu standing in front of you. So what does Sir John do? Oh, yes.
Yeah, he's typing.
Okay, I keep hitting with a cast iron frying pan. So no, give me.
He didn't. He said that a while ago. It's he's typing something new up.
Okay. Heals
heal
everyone.
Anyone. Yep. So he's going to heal.
Doug.
Doug, because Doug needs it.
Okay.
And I'll be
okay.
Right back because my roommate just pulled up. So be right.
Okay. Yeah, and I'm going to have to take a break in just a second. So, Jet Li, what is Jet Li? You continue your grapple of Venu?
Yeah. To take an action, I'd have to break the grapple, so.
Okay. So, Dan? So, what does Dan do?
I think he had to step away for a minute because of
roommate. Yeah, he had to step away for a minute. Just came in, yeah.
Okay. Now's a good time for a break.
Yeah, now's a good time for a break. Go get your tea.
Okay, I will. Okay, so we'll do that. And let me see. Caitlin Stormcrow. We'll do that. Let me just put Caitlin, and that's Archie is a female monk, but what race?
Human. Oh, I forgot to put that down, didn't I? Yeah.
Yeah, human. Okay, and that's a monk, female. Okay, and we'll put that first level. Okay, let's take a pause for 1 second. Then will I go get my tea and such, and then we'll come back.
All right. In the meantime, I'll give you guys a quickie intro here. Because this is an old character that I used to play in the third edition. During my Neverwinter Nights gameplay. And I had such a rich history with it, I didn't want to give it up yet. But then again, this is the first level... starting over, because it wouldn't be fair for everybody else to just bring in a 20th level monk into the game. So, I figure I'd go ahead and have a
20th level monk would have been too much.
Yeah. What happened was that she has a background where she was trying to gain enlightenment through sex.
No.
But... Yeah, I mean...
More hot girl on girl action.
So, but unfortunately, I guess this is the excuse I'm using to try to bring it back to first level. There are a number of, let's say, demonic-type beings like succubi who do not appreciate a human trying to muscle in on their action. Especially one as potently powerful as her. So, I was going to have is that they ambushed her, tied her ass down, and just to make her suffer, because killing would be too good for her, drained her all the way back to level 1.
Whoa. And then she gets kidnapped and brought to this island and told she's got to fight the
They left her to fend on her own, and where she came from, how she got here, she doesn't even know. For that matter, I'm going to go ahead and say, because the succubi could plane shift for that matter, They brought her to this whole new world and said, fuck you, and there you go. So she is just a royal F you to her all the way around.
Hey, I just assumed he went into...
How does that sound to you?
Reputable massage parlor, and it ended up being like a wife that was in there giving you a little shiatsu. That dropped you pretty quick. I like that you don't even know what to say to that.
Anyway, I have my image up on my screen in case you want to go ahead and get the little view there. I took a little time to actually prepare an overlay so you guys can see the whole thing.
Where's the overlay?
If you look at the image of me in the Hangout, you actually see my character picture on this side here.
The bald dude with the glasses?
Huh?
All I see is a picture of a bald dude with glasses.
Yeah, the image.
Bald dude with glasses? That's not me.
Yeah, that's the image I see.
Really? Oh yeah. No, that maybe you have the bandwidth set low, so you're not seeing the picture. Let me go ahead and get you a link.
So I'm back. So where, what was it? We were waiting for who are we waiting for?
Me.
Okay. So Doug was. Let's see. Was it? No. Who was me?
That was Dan, I think.
Dan. Okay. Dan, so what does Dan do?
I'm sorry, I was helping my roommate.
You had Sir John. I thought it was Sir John was trying to heal you.
No, Sir John was trying to heal Doug, who was still laying on the ground at 0 health points. I'm at 1 health point.
Oh, okay. Doug is.
Doug got 10, so Doug's back at 10 health points.
Okay, Doug is at 10. Okay, so that's...
But it's still Dan's turn.
So it's Dan. Yeah, Dan.
All right, since we now know it's Venu, I'm going to draw my longsword and point it at its throat and say, what the hell do you think you're doing?
Okay, that's Dan. Xanatar, what does Xanatar do? Noah?
Is everyone healed back up?
No.
No. And is the changeling still attacking? He's still alive, yeah?
He's still alive, yes.
Okay, I will go at him then.
Okay.
So I will, I will attack with my quarterstaff.
Okay.
Or 18.
To hit.
6 points of damage.
Okay. Krista's still talking with Ranella.
You
heard, okay, you
yes,
heard
I
some
am.
Tapping at the door.
Okay, but we didn't open it, and if she got scared, I just put my arm around her and said, just relax, be quiet. They'll never know we're in here.
Yeah, as a bonus action on my turn, before it's over, I turn into a giant toad.
The prince. We're going to kiss you.
Okay, so then...
Okay, so does she tell me anything at all yet?
And she says, give me a persuasion roll. And what are you trying to find?
Anything that she might tell me that, you know, just in general talking. She's scared. She might just tell me, you know, anything. I'm not trying to pry anything out of her. Just hoping she'll kind of... say something. You know,
okay.
People do when they're scared and they start talking.
So she's definitely worried about Venu, And she says, well, here she reaches down and under the dresser, pulls out this small wooden box. And he says, well, we can have some of this, and it will help ease the fear. And so she opens up the box, and there's this chopped up green leafy stuff, and she says, have a little bit of this. And so she
don't know how to roll.
No, she doesn't. No, you don't roll it. She just takes it and chews it and swallows it. And she takes a bit of a pinch of it and says, here, try some.
I'm going to ask her what it is, and I rolled 20 for persuasion.
Okay, that's what that. Yeah, she says, this stuff is... Venu gets the best of this. And then she goes, you'll enjoy it. Try it. You'll like it.
Well, I'm going to take it from her, and I'm going to kind of palm it and pretend I take it, but not really, and stuff it into my component's pouch to look later.
give me a dexterity check to see that you do that without her noticing.
All right, just a sec.
Okay.
Yeah, I bet she's going to see me do that.
She says, no, not. If you want some for later, don't worry about that. Here, it's actually, she puts, okay, do I do this? She says, normally, Xanatar and I share it with a kiss, but yeah, she says I'm not. She says here, just open your mouth and I'll put some in.
I'm just not sure. Can I wait and see how? I'm not sure if I'm allergic to it.
You'll enjoy it, and he says, and it really cuts the edge off of these stressful times.
Okay, but I'm not stressed, darling. I think maybe says, you might need more of it. So how about we just wait, because we don't know when Jonathan will be back.
Okay, you don't know what you're missing. So she puts it back, puts that back in the box, then puts the box down and slides it under the dresser.
Now, okay, is she
your
getting
magic, you did detect magic on this substance.
Okay, good.
That would have been on there. Now then, that's Krista.
Now, is she like getting relaxed? Should I lay her down in bed and sort of her comfy?
Let's go on to the next character. Let's go. She's just do it. Doug. So you're.
Yes.
So Doug. Oh, you were healed to 10 hit points. So what do you do now?
I get up. I'm gonna pull out
Okay. Let's make the situation. You just got healed. Oh, it was Sir John who healed you.
Yeah.
That's right. Sir John healed you, but Sir John was the one who also sent you, knocked you out. So what do you do?
Well, I get up and I assess the situation. I see that one is bloodied and one is not.
No. There's only one Sir John now. There's a Venu that's being grappled by Jet Li, but there's only one Sajan.
Okay, well, I kind of suspected that. I just ask, is that the guy that looked like you? I look at Sajan, the real Sajan. Okay. Did he look like you a minute ago?
Okay, so now then, we'll let him, when he gets to his turn, we'll let him answer. Then it's Olog.
Alright, I'm going to search the guys that we killed outside, and I'm going to take a look around and listen to see if there's
you find, by now, I believe the one spell that sort of killed them would have wore off, so you find them, they have some more pearls, and they have some Shigan spears and swords, and they also have some oyster shells with some sort of writing on the inside of the oyster shells.
All right, well, I'll retrieve my arrows,
okay.
Take the pearls, and the oyster shells.
Okay. Then we have Alar.
All right, I'm going to have Alar. No, I'm going to have him go outside, climb the wall back up to the Widow's Walk, and keep an eye out for anything more, just in case, because spiders don't really need to sleep. They sort of sit there and meditate a little bit, but they always have their tremor sense, they have their dark vision.
So then it would be Sajan. Oh, and Sajan. Okay. Are you going to heal or roll, or what are you doing?
Well, he answered my question yes, and he said be right back.
Okay, so we'll
see. AC 15 if attacked.
Okay, so.
Oh, wait, no, that's Jet Li. Never mind.
Okay, so we'll skip over Sajan. Jet Li, what does Jet Li do?
Sorry, I'm back. So I'm still grappled. Did something happen while I walked away? Yes.
So the Sajan you were grappling is now Venu.
Oh, right. But is he in my arms? Lovingly.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm just going to continue to grapple him so the party can still do what they need to do to him, and he's at disadvantage. So.
Okay. We'll get to Caitlin in a minute, but that would be next. That we'll do that one next round, unless we figure out what's going on. So now it's Dan's turn.
Venu never answered my question.
Oh, Venu never asked your question. Your question. What was your question again?
What the hell is he doing?
Oh, his response was to attack. So. He didn't respond. All right,
then I'm going to do an unarmed strike to knock him unconscious.
Okay.
Because unarmed strikes cannot kill.
Okay, and you have advantage.
What does that mean?
Roll two d20s and take the higher.
All right. Aha. Well, I rolled a natural 20.
Okay.
So, unarmed strike, that's a D8 or is that a D6? I can't remember.
I think it's only D6.
All right. We'll go with that. Well, I did 6 damage.
6.
Well, plus my strength modifier, which is 1, so 7 damage.
Okay. Okay. Now then, Xanatar.
I'm gonna bite that fool.
That's a toad. Okay.
Yeah, this toad's wondering what human legs taste like.
18. I think you hit.
Alright, so I do 1d10 damage to him. Plus 2. So that's 10 damage. Plus an additional 1d10 poison. Which is just 1. And the target is grapple. And restrain.
Okay, so he's unconscious.
All right.
He's unconscious. Okay.
Do monsters go unconscious?
Well, you did. The reason that he went unconscious was because he had 7 points of... What was the... It was 7 points of non-lethal damage. Because who was it that attacked him? That was Dan attacked him with non-lethal force. So that's why he went unconscious. So now then, the entire party. Okay. Krista and Ranella are in the back room. What happens now? Now we've got. Caitlin is now with us also, so...
I'm gonna suggest something. And I asked Sage Jin Anson that he said that this was the guy that looked like him. So I recommend we kill him and bury him out back before we let the lady out. And we'll just say, he never came back.
No, we saw the Sahawagin carry him away.
Should I swallow the evidence?
Sure. Why not? Search him first, though.
Yeah, absolutely.
We can search him later. If you know what I mean.
No, we're not doing that.
Let's carry him out back. We can loot while we're digging the hole.
Well, he's unconscious right now.
Well, somebody
kick. He ain't dead.
Step on his head. Seriously.
I can't kill an unconscious.
I knocked him out so we can interrogate him later.
Yeah. Well, no, he's just a dick. Just kill him.
Let me check my morality code real quick.
So you're okay with swallowing him, but you're not okay with...
He's a doppelganger that sucker-punched me.
Well, go ahead. Go sneak up on him. I can't see what's going on. I can't judge
you. He's down, so you could do a... He's there.
I pull out my dagger, and I slit his throat.
My conscience is clean.
Done. Let's bury it.
Okay.
Jet Li's bowing out.
Okay.
He's going back to bed. He's like,
Yeah, he's gonna go meditate again.
Okay. So. After you slit his throat, the body changes into a very gray. It no longer has the shape of Venu. It changes shape into a gray humanoid. All right. And as you, So about at this point, I guess, what does Krista do? Do you... Krista, you and
you're muted.
Yeah, I know. I unmuted and then it just went back to being muted again. Sorry. I'm still in the room with what's her name there, Ranella.
Anyway,
Ranella. I'm going to. Is she getting like she needs to lay down or anything yet, or sleepy or anything like that?
She's her. Eyes have a bit of a, shall we say, a glazed look.
Okay, I'm going to suggest to her, would you like to lie down while we wait for Venu to return?
She says, yeah, The new often wakes me in a very special way.
There we go. So how about you get right here under the covers and wait for the new?
And she goes, okay.
Okay. Yes, got her into bed.
That's what you've been trying to do. You've been trying to get into her drawers and get her into bed all night long.
All night long. Finally succeeded. Okay.
Okay.
That's okay. My turn. I'm going to. I'm sure she's got a chair in there. I'm going to sit on the chair and just kind of let her go to sleep and keep an eye on that glowing spot underneath that dresser.
Okay. Now then. So that's Krista. What does the rest of the party do now? Now you got this body. So you've got a dead body of a gray creature in clothing. And so you, what do you do? You.
I don't know, but.
I showed the rest of the party the voices I have with the strange writing.
Okay, so the oyster shells, we're in the world of Tiglath. What happens is that writing is a little odd. It's not your normal writing. These are scratched into the inside of oyster shells. It takes a bit. Give me a perception roll to see if you can identify, if you can actually read the scratches on the inside of the oyster shell.
At this point, Doug goes and knocks on the bedroom door and says, all clear.
18?
Yeah.
Okay. So, what happens is that the oyster shell says, need assistance, come to the home, prepared for battle. So,
how big are these stones?
No, they're not stones, they're oyster shells. And
how big are oyster shells?
What?
Like clam shells.
Well, these oyster shells are a little bit larger. They're, say, maybe 6 inches across. So they're large oyster shells, and what happens is it's faintly scribed into them, but it's scratched into the oyster shell, and it's in an unusual variant of common, and it says, need assistance, come to the house, prepared for battle.
I think we need to have a serious conversation with this woman.
She's not in any condition to give a serious talk to anyone right now. But I think we've taken care of the. We came prepared for battle.
But so I'm going to suggest to the party that we tell her a variation of the truth, such as the gray creature came up looking like. What's his face?
Vanu.
And then he attacked the party, so we had to kill him.
Vanu tried to save us, but it got eaten by the creature, so we slayed the creature.
That works too.
But poor Vanu.
Okay, so do we still have the frog and the spider?
I was gonna say, wait a minute. I haven't even opened the door yet to let you guys in. I'm not buying that knock, knock, knock. All clear.
The spider is up on the roof.
Can I do a persuasion check?
So what we should be doing? We knock and tell you it was all clear when it was all clear.
Well, yeah, but I mean, you know, you could be being forced to say that. You have to tell me more. But then I don't. I'm going to maybe I'll open the door a little bit and peek out and then say she's sleeping.
Okay.
Doug shoves a turnover under the door.
Done. Open the door. Hi. How you doing? best turnovers ever. Okay, shh, she's sleeping.
So you know it's me, right? It's my ID.
I do, yep. That's your ID. I open the door happily and go, what happened? She's asleep on the bed.
Yeah, close the door. Come on, we got some talking to do.
Wait a minute, there's some magic in here. There's some really good shit in here.
Well, don't lock it. Just come on.
She'll never let us back in. Let me go get this first. You keep an eye on her and let me see if I can get this out of her drawer first, okay?
Okay. I'm going to make an assumption that you guys, shall we say, loot the body of Venu. Is that a reasonable assumption?
Yeah, that's what Dan's going to do.
Okay. Can you hear me?
I'm sure everybody there is going to do that, but me, I'm in the bedroom still looting the bed.
Yes, we hear you.
Okay. Hey, I want to do a check on him, like he is.
So...
knowledge check.
Okay.
Identify the body, what it is.
Yeah, while he does that, Ogles for pockets.
Okay, so what happens is that the give me your roll.
I think he's talking to you there, Archie.
Say again.
Yeah.
Okay.
My apologies. Right.
I'm just coming in and out a little bit. Well, somebody just roll me a d20.
I'll roll it.
3 to it.
Okay, yeah. You got a 18 plus 3, 21. So you determine that this is... okay. In World of Tiglath, they're a variant... Well, okay. They're technically a Va'oder, but what happens is that you would know them as... doppelganger. This goes back to when I was running the 4th edition. I had problems with the definition of 5th edition doppelganger because it broke some things that I wanted, and so I have Va'oders, which are for all intents and purposes doppelgangers. There's some difference in the way they reproduce and such. The argument is that doppelgangers are renegade Va'oders. But anyway, so as you so it's a doppelganger. When you loot the body, you find some more pearls, and what he was attacking with were two pearl-handled daggers and the hilts on the pommel of the dagger are the symbol of multiple faces.
If no one claims them, I'll take them. Or if someone wants one, I'll take the other. That's Dan.
Actually, Noah may remember some of these, but that would be giving some. That's because he was in the previous campaign. But
mum's the word.
What?
Mum's the word.
Mum's the word. Okay.
Screw it. I have no interest in the daggers anyway.
Yeah. So yeah. Some people have run into that symbol before in this campaign. So anyway, but we'll go from there. So the also let me see here. There is a
Let me find that. And that would have been, that you find a small ceramic cylinder, and there we go. Okay. And it says, and it says it's a small ceramic cylinder, and it's written. Okay, we're in the world of Tiglath, which is Bronze Age. Paper doesn't exist. What people write on is that they write on either clay or wax tablets, or they can write on other things like various clay forms like cylinders and things like that. So there's some writing. It's cuneiform writing is on the cylinder, and the cylinder says says we're in the name of Adra, we're making progress. And that's all.
Do we know who Adra is?
Okay.
So there's also a phrase that says, at this point, no, you don't.
Okay.
So, what does the party do now? So now you've got Ranella, who is sleeping.
Crystal's looting.
Krista.
So what's Krista doing? Or what is
Krista went back because she was sleeping. Krista went into the room, and when Doug told her that it all was clear, she opened the door. Doug showed her his calling card. She opened the door. He's watching over her.
Yeah.
While I go to that drawer, open it, and take that ring.
Okay.
And she's standing in between, so that Doug is standing in between, so she won't see me if she should wake up. And hopefully it won't make any squeaks. Ah.
Okay. So, all right. So you've got this silver ring with an obsidian.
Okay. I'm just going to slide it into my component pouch and zippers. Close my component's pouch.
Hold the drawstring, yes.
Yeah, and let her just continue sleeping and leave the room. But we're going to leave the door open this time. Prop wide open. I want to see if somebody gets in there from there might be a magic spot under here. I let you know, Doug. Under this dresser, there might be a magic spot. She's got a box that's really cool stuff too. Can we take it out too? Let's take it out. So we're gonna lift. Can we take the box with us?
Oh, you can like examine that box.
The magic. But
I'd like to take it out first.
The magic is all in the box.
Oh, good. Okay, then I'm that going
sounds,
to lift.
That sounds kind of dirty too, but.
Well, you know, you got me checking her drawers and, you know, putting her into bed, so why not have the magic in the box?
You know, it's not the size of the box, it's the magic that's in it.
There you go. I'm going to pick up the box and take it out into the other room while she is enjoying her little snooze.
Okay.
As long as, you know, I mean, we're doing it quietly, hopefully. We don't wake her.
So,
All right, so now you're all back together, so tell me what you're telling each other. What are you asking about? What are you trying to do?
Okay, everybody, one, two, three. Talk at once!
Except for Michael, who has to drop off, and then we'll be back.
It ain't easy being green.
Oh, I bet it is. Look at this box of green stuff. I bet you could be green real easy with this.
That's a frog reference.
Is that happy stuff that she ate?
She took this and got really looped and laid down for a nap, and her eyes were glazing.
She's probably going to need that in the days to come. I'd probably put that down.
Yeah, that's why I think we should take control of it, because we can mete it out to her slowly. Gonna be,
as a druid, would I know what this stuff is?
Give me a roll.
11 plus whatever you want to be.
Give me your wisdom.
My wisdom's 20.
Okay, your wisdom modifier is
5.
Okay, so it's Tharl. So Tharl is a
it's a hallucinogenic drug that's also a relaxant and also conveys the ability to breathe underwater.
Yes. Yes. This is also. So what happens is that
it's also highly addictive.
You know this, yes.
Not so cool.
So yes, Tharl provides Tharl is often used by the Shogun. They give Tharl to their captives. And what happens is it conveys water breathing, but it also, even if they're in oxygen, or that, they tend to become, shall we say, somewhat docile, and it is addictive. It's the, shall we say, the perfect thing to do for the Shogun prisoners, because you know, once you've been with Tharl for a while, you know, you actually don't want to run away from the Shogun.
Is there a remedy, or you have to, like, detox slowly?
You have to detox.
And is it a bad detox?
What happens is that the detox is not too terribly bad, but what happens is that often people who've been on Tharl enjoy the option to go back to Tharl.
So in order to keep her off it, we're going to have to put her in a nunnery or something.
Oh, come on, everybody knows that.
Or we could just score her some more Gnarl or something.
Best place to score drugs.
Well, we were trying to protect her from the news, so I think we now have a moral obligation to look after her.
Well, I would call that mission success.
Yeah, he's not coming back.
Well, yes, but the Shwagan might. Shwagan? Shwagan. They may. Those guys, those frog people. They might come back, so we ought to at least take her to a monastery, the next monastery we find, and leave her in their care if we don't help her get off this stuff.
Let's see how she reacts to...
to being Vanu off this stuff?
Well, and the fact that Vanu's not coming back.
Yeah, the fact that he died.
Yeah. Well, I don't think we should tell her. Just let her keep asking.
If he killed him, then we killed it.
Okay, well, she might be happy with that, eh? How long will she stay asleep with this stuff?
How long will she sleep with this stuff? Depends upon how much you ingested, the amount she ingested, because she was actually tired and a little bit frightened, so
she's going to be out for maybe you could wake her up, but she would be you could wake her up, but she's going to be, shall we say, under the effects for maybe the next 10 to 12 hours.
Yeah, I don't want to wake her up. That's why I was hoping she'd, you know, that we wouldn't have to wake her up.
Another side effect of Thorol, as you may have known, is it does tend to increase sexual pleasure, but that's a...
Well, okay. Which one of you guys wants to sit in here with her?
Great game. Bye.
You don't want to sit in there, eh?
Once you go elf, you never go back.
Okay, you sit in there with her.
You have to... You ought to read The Fallible Fiend by Le Sprague de Camp. That is actually hilarious, talking about... It's one of those... Fallible Fiend. Yeah, The Fallible Fiend by L. Sprague de Camp. I wonder if they've got it on here. Because I've got... If you want something up, it's hilarious talking about Practical Demon. This is Zadim. And anyway, but we'll and the phrase "thou would slay me with such a tool" will just crack you up. But anyway, so as we move on.
So John says that his connection is failing and that he will support casting the cantrip Guidance.
I see that. So. So we've got what does the party want to do now?
Dan's gonna go meditate for 4 hours in the bedroom to keep watch over the woman to make sure no harm comes to her in any way, shape, or form.
Doug will drag the body of Vanu outside.
Okay, so you've got the bodies of six Shogun and a doppelganger.
Mm-hmm. We have to take the bodies. We have to do something with them, not just leave them outside. We don't want to attract attention, flies, bugs, whatever. Who's got special digging powers? Oh!
Light them on fire.
Xanatar, turn into something that digs so we can bury these critters.
Or you can turn into a giant snake and eat them.
Ew.
They'd be
Are you hungry? Yeah, but then he has to digest them, and snakes take forever to digest.
A married man, because nobody can dig holes faster than that.
Okay, yes.
Bad pun.
Oh, I... Okay. So he's a married man digging holes.
I don't know. I guess I'll turn into like a giant badger or something like that, and then I function as a backhoe.
Okay. It'd be easier to just light him on fire.
I could do that. Yeah, but then that might attract attention too, so maybe burying them is better. Yeah. I vote for burying.
I can turn into a giant cat and bury him in the sand like a turd.
You could do that. Whatever works, but I just think burying them is better than attracting attention with a fire. And I also think that, an animal could dig way faster than we could.
Unless it's still alive.
We could always burn them later.
True. In the morning.
Well, no, I don't want them hanging around. If he had magic in him, I want him gone before morning.
No, we can bury him now, and then later on when she goes to market or something, we can dig him up and burn him.
Torch him? That means I'm not going to market. Drats. No shopping for me.
What do you do it with a torch and a little fuel?
A torch, some oil from the lamp. Yeah, it would go up just like a candle.
It's really hard to start bodies on fire. Have you ever seen a funeral pyre? They have to build them like really, really big. Or a lot. So like you have to get the temperature up to like 2,000, 3,000 degrees. Something like that. Something crazy.
Yeah,
only magic power is going to do that.
That's why people always have this problem with the dead. You know, the bodies don't they don't burn all the way up.
Mm-hmm.
So big hole it is.
Start backhoeing there, our okay. Badger, dear badger.
so you backhoe. So this was in the evening. This was after dusk. So the combat went on for a while. So it would have been even darker. So you, as you dig the holes here, are you burying them in front of the house and behind the closer to the beach, back farther? What are you doing in relation to the house?
Not too close.
I don't want to get closest to the beach where I can get rushed. But I'll get him into the soft sand.
Okay, so dig the soft sand to the north or south of the house, or behind the house, in front of the house.
Away from the house, at least 100 feet, 100 yards.
Which direction?
Towards the water? Isn't that where sand is?
Okay, yeah. So because the house is farther way above the. So you're dig the hole, you put the bodies in. And bury them. Give me a perception check.
I'm meditating in the bedroom with the woman, so.
Okay.
And I haven't left the house. I'm not leaving either.
Doug got an 18.
Okay, so.
24.
So, for those you remember, there when you were earlier closer to the ocean, you saw something out on at night. You saw something moving off in the distance, offshore, in against the something moving on the surface of the water, quite a ways from shore. You see something. Moving closer, you see something with some lights on it, moving closer to coming toward shore. It's off in the distance. It was probably maybe, what's the curvature of the world? How far away can you see before it goes off the edge? With the curvature before it goes the
so
right side?
20 miles.
20 miles. Okay, yeah. So these was probably 10 miles offshore, and it's coming towards shore. You see something as you're digging, it appears to be coming closer and closer to the shore slowly. It's not moving rapidly. But it's moving, and you can see that there are some glowing spots on it, shall we say.
So is Ortiz entering now?
So is what?
Our new character, our new party member, is joining?
Yes, he's with you. Krista, Caitlin.
Yes.
So, yes, you're with them now, digging the grave.
Okay, so basically I'm wandering in here at this point?
Yeah.
All right. So, just to give you an idea of what I look like also. Basically, I'm dressed in what appears to be a leather loincloth with a leather top. With two tattoos on her legs, both for dragons facing each other, with leather boots, and black gloves.
Okay.
Odd thing about her, besides her platinum blonde hair, which is almost white, is the fact that she actually has her lipstick or whatever it is actually green.
Okay.
And my hair is disheveled. I'm in a daze. Basically, I'm just walking in the direction. I'm not sure where I'm walking at, but I'm just know to go forward.
Okay. So now then, so you're you've had this. You've dug the graves. You're burying the bodies. You see something coming toward shore. You guesstimate that it will probably be here maybe around 8 or 9 in the morning based at the distance that it's coming and the speed that it's traveling.
And what time is it now?
Well, it's about midnight. So what do you do?
Graves.
Well, boats.
That's the worst I've seen.
Got about 40 or 50 people on board, so we could hang out and wait for them.
Well, I think Doug's going to go in and go back to bed.
Okay, so Doug goes back into bed. He goes back in and goes back to bed. Okay.
I'm gonna hide and wait for him.
Okay, so you go back into the house and hide.
No, I mean not on the beach.
And the spider sees them.
Well, the spider sees. Okay, spider would. It's.
Spider sees like 8,000 of whatever we see.
Yeah. Okay. So.
Yeah.
All right. So. You spend the evening on the beach or in the house, or what do you do? What do you do with?
Have we buried the bodies now? Pat the ground down and...
Yeah, we'll assume that you buried the bodies.
Wow, we're fast. It's only midnight.
Well, that is all in a tree up in 1808.
Say that again? I didn't catch all of that.
Thanatar will go and meditate in a tree in 1808.
Oh, okay.
Just south of the house.
Okay, so it should be 1608, I think it would be 16.
No, 18, just south of the house. To the right?
Oh, okay.
Right there.
Oh, actually, you're close. You're over here. That's the town that you ran away from.
I thought that wasn't just like the house the whole time. I was like, man, that thing is huge.
No. That's the city that you ran away from, and this is a town. That's a town.
Then I'll gather up a bunch of seaweed and take a nap, like in the seaweed.
Okay. So, in the you spend a relatively uneventful evening. The rest of the evening. You wake up. The sun is shining. It's another clear, beautiful day, and off in the distance, coming toward the shore, is a fairly large, unusually shaped sail ship, and it's sailing toward the house and beach that you guys are on. So what do you do?
Well, Alar is going to stand statue still watching them so that they don't notice him. If they do notice him, they're just probably just going to think that he's some sort of fanatic statue that she collected over the years.
What time is it now, Jeffy?
So it's about 8 a.m. The ship is about
up.
Okay. You've been up, yes. You woke up. So yes. So you woke up about 6:30. What are we doing around the house? What are we doing? You know.
Dan's gonna stay in the room and keep an eye on the woman. Like I said.
So if
he's needed, the spider will come get him.
Have Dan do a perception check.
I'm also in the room, so that in case she wakes up freaked out, she won't be.
So both of you do a perception check, Dan and Krista.
Right. Oh, not very perceptive this morning. Still sleeping. I just gotta find it. And total, oh, come on.
And what did Dan get?
Hold on, I'm looking up my bonus.
Ooh. Perception wisdom.
Yep, I got 20 overall.
I got, yeah, I didn't.
Okay, so...
I got 11.
What, you detect that there is, and it's just from the shape of the room and where the bed is and such, you're pretty sure something is a little unusual about the... that there might be something, what's the phrase, hidden on the one wall.
What did you say?
May I do an investigation check then?
Sure.
All right. Got another 16, but that's only a plus 2, so it's 18.
Okay. So, all right. So this is where I actually drew this up. This is the farmhouse. So if you remember, there was, you come in here, there's barred windows. This is the very large master bedroom that Krista and Ranella have been hiding in. And these windows have bars on them, and that the shutter, they can close the shutters. That there is, this is the staircase going up. There, behind this, there's a staircase going down. This is the kitchen where you've been cooking, and then here's the dining room where you've been eating, but this is the first floor. What happens is you detect that there's a, you find this passage. There's actually a closet here. I need to draw that in. That there actually is a closet where you found some linen and such, but that there is also hidden a passageway with a ladder going up. And so you've got something happened. So why don't we, because we normally go until 11:30, and I was thinking of stopping just a few minutes early because this would be a good cliffhanger. How does that sound?
Okay.
All right. All right.
I'm just trying to figure out how I'm going to go ahead and pop in the middle of this.
So, okay. So let's take a look here. So what would happen is we'll just do so now I gotta figure out who all, okay, so let's stop the broadcast. I'll figure out some experience.